Hello and welcome to the Slingshot Channel. In order to celebrate 5 years of Slingshot Channel history, I've decided to make another big slingshot. It's a replica of a famous weapon from The Hobbit, the Peter Jackson movie trilogy. A big crossbow that is used to fire at Smaug the dragon. And it's a crossbow with four arms.
So here you can see a few pictures from the original movie The Hobbit. And that's actually Geryon, the last Lord of Dale. And that's the original attack from Smaug. And here you can see him firing the big crossbow with the four arms and the long, long arrow, the black arrow. And you can also see him from a different perspective here. You can see it's a long arrow and four arms. And you can also see some details here. You see that there is a sled, which is probably very heavy. And you can also see that it is hooked into something that looks like a windlass. You can see that the whole sled is also transported to the front. So I believe that that's not ideal, because I think it's too heavy and it takes up too much energy. And also it needs to be decelerated, which can cause a lot of trouble, because it will be as fast as the arrow at the end of this motion. So I think that I will also employ a sled, but when I employ a sled, it will stay behind so that only the string will be accelerated together with the arrow. Also, I think I will make the whole weapon longer, but I will have to keep the arms a lot shorter, because I will use rubber instead of wood, of course. This is the Slingshot Channel. Other than that, I think I will try to maintain as much of the original weapon as possible. Like this typical, like, Maxim MG stance that you can see here. It's kind of cool. And also I want this one-man operation principle. And the long, long arrows. Very cool.
So here is my replica arrow. It's one of it. And we're gonna test several designs against an artificial Smaug scale that I've made. Here's the Smaug scale. It's made from 1/2-inch plywood, furniture grade plywood, very solid. And it's armored with a stainless steel plate. And this cannot be penetrated by a bow and arrow, and also not by a crossbow bolt. And we need to test if it can be penetrated by the long arrow. And here is the weapon that I built to hunt dragons. Let me show you some detail. This uses a lot of rubber. There's over 7 meters of full width Therabend gold on it, with over 200 kilograms of draw force. And it's stretched to over 35 meters when in cocked condition. And as you see, like the original movie weapon, it has four arms. That's an awful lot of draw force. And it can only be cocked by a winch. And the winch is operated by this wooden rod as a lever. So this is how it's operated. Okay, today we won't be showing the wheel shooting, because on Wednesday we will have a film team from a North American television channel here. And then we will upload a new video with lots of action. So, I hope you like this, because that's it for today. Thanks and bye bye.